Stories are so important, and for relationships, stories are very important. This is a story of just how important it is. There was a king who had a beautiful house and beautiful wife, and he marries her, and shortly after their marriage, she begins to fade. Her beauty becomes sunken in, and her face kind of like a prune. Her body is shriveled, and her life just seems to have gone out of her. And she just looks so depressed. And all she would do was walk around the kingdom and walk around that castle and go, "I'm bored." And the king would go and do the things that the king would do. Being worried about his wife, he was asking the wise men of his court, "Why is she like this? What has happened? Why is she looking and acting this way? Does anybody know?" And they thought, "There's a peasant, a farmer who's very poor that lives in the village. And that farmer has a beautiful wife. She's full and she's happy. And when you walk by, she's always smiling and working in her garden." The king says, "Bring him to me. Let him tell me what's wrong with my wife." So they brought this poor man to the king, and the king looked at him and says, "Tell me why your wife is poor, but she is so filled and happy, and my wife, who has everything, is so sullen and sickly. What do you do for your wife?" And the farmer looked and says, "I feed her the meat of the tongue." "The meat of the tongue?" "Yes, the meat of the tongue." Well, he dismisses the farmer, and he calls his cooks and says, "I want you to start feeding my wife tongue. Whatever kind of tongue, feed her." So they start getting tongue. They go to the butcher, and they get chicken tongues. I've never heard of a chicken tongue. They get cow tongues. They even chased frogs and got frog tongues. And every day that she had tongue, baked tongue, fried tongue, fricasseed tongue, 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 tongue. And for months, they fed her tongue. And she was still sad, and she was still down. So they called for the farmer again. "You told me to feed her tongue, and it's not worked. I've given her the meat of the tongue, and nothing has happened." And the king says, "I know what I'll do. You take my wife, and I will take yours." And there they swapped. And every day the farmer would come home, and he would spend time with the king's wife, and they would talk. And she would tell the stories of his day. And they would just talk and laugh, and she'd work. And before you know it, this solemn woman started to have light in her eyes again. And the more they would eat, and the more they would talk, and the more she worked in the garden, the happier she was. And she became, once again, the beauty that the king had married. Well, the farmer's wife, now having the lap of luxury, could have anything and everything that she could ever want, walked around the place going, "I'm bored." And over the weeks, her face began to sink in. She began to lose weight and become sickly. When the king was looking at her and seeing what was wrong and hearing from the village how his wife has changed, he grabs the farmer's wife, and they go and they travel to the house of the farmer. And when they pull up, in the garden is the king's wife. And he looks out and sees that she is beautiful again. And he looks and he says, "What's going on? Why are you so beautiful? Why have you changed? What does he give you that I don't give you?" And she replied, "The meat of the tongue. The meat of the tongue, I don't understand." So they all went inside. And the king learned that every day the farmer would come in, and they would sit and they would talk and they would share the day, share their stories. And that brought her life. The king learned a valuable lesson that it doesn't matter how much you provide, that if you don't share the stories of your life, if you don't give the meat of the tongue, your marriage will not be happy. So I share with you today the meat of the tongue, that your lives may be rich. And that is my story.